Orchestra, and we are excited to present you with this fourth episode of Migrating Music. My name is Daniel.
I'm Yupi.
I'm Haley.
I'm Marie.
In this episode, we'll be playing Béla Bartók's Romanian folk dances. Bartók was a Hungarian pianist, composer, and ethnomusicologist. Who remembers what is the work of an ethnomusicologist?
An ethnomusicologist studies the music from around the world.
That's right, Maria, and Bartók was one of the most influential collectors and transporters of folk music in the 20th century. He traveled with a phonograph and recorded Hungarian, Slovak, and Romanian folk songs and wrote them down. He loved the sounds and rhythms of Romanian folk music and used them as models for the piece that we will play for you today. In Romania, traditional folk music is very much alive, even today. It's typical to watch ensembles as well as dancers perform on an everyday basis in rural and urban areas. Between the years 1909 and 1914, more than 100 years ago, Bartók would take field trips to Transylvania, which is now in Romania. He would travel with his phonograph and invite musicians to play into his big horn. Some of these recordings Bartók made during his field trips are available for us to hear today. Let's hear some of them.
Exploring all this music in Romania and inviting musicians to play into your phonograph? For this piece, there were two fiddlers playing. I could hear one playing the melody and another one accompanying with longer notes. That tune became the first movement of Bartók's Romanian folk dances, titled Zhou Long, Bâta, or Dance with Sticks. We'll play Bartók's version for you, and then we can compare it to the original song recorded in the phonograph. Here's Bartók's Dance with Sticks. Yes, Bartók loved folk music. The process that Bartók went through in this piece started by recording the songs, and then he added accompaniment as well as an introduction and a conclusion. And now that music is available to be played all around the world. Let's now hear Bartók's second movement, Brâul, or Waistband Dance. Thank you.
And here is the recording used to make that piece. That recording was made by a local encounter with a flautist. Again, the melody stays intact. Bartók added accompaniment, and that was it. The melody starts in the viola and then appears in the first violin, but the notes themselves remain faithful in the recording.
A lot of the original songs remain the same. That is the essence of migrant music that we wanted to share with you. A lot is preserved from the place where it comes from, but some of it is influenced by the movement and the places it goes through. Bartók keeps a lot of original songs, but also adds his own style and accompaniment to it. I think it's a little bit like making foreign meals. Like, you might not get every ingredient that you envision, but it may still taste delicious. Last, we have three fast dances, Romanian polka, and two Creek dances.
In the last dance, you can hear people clapping along. Now we'll play Bartók's version of these three dances. They'll be played without interruption, but you will be able to tell when we move from one dance to the next because the music will change as in the recording. When we get to the last dance, you can clap along as the people did in this recording more than 100 years ago.